And we are back on Champion Spring, guys, and the MVP is Duke for that top lane rumble play. He really made a difference with those huge equalizers.
Yeah, great team fighting, great initiation. Hard to pick an MVP this game, kind of all very well all around played by NaJin.
It was, yeah.
And they really just looked very comfortable with that team composition. They pushed their power spike extremely well, snowballed that game beautifully.
Well, you know, we had that moment where we're like, you know, will NaJin do what they need to do and get the edge they need to finish this early? And they did exactly that.
Wow, look at this.
This was a great snipe right there. Yeah.
No, if you look at that rumble, I want to go back to that because he actually hit him in the brush and then hit his escape route on the W jump,
yeah,
too. That is crazy good rumble ult right there. And another excellent one as we see them just clean up. And Duke's going to actually live through this, surprisingly, the rest of his team running up the lane.
Yeah.
Duke kind of walking around the outside of his own equalizer, saving that flash.
Oh,
he didn't have his flash there. That's right. He actually gets...
Well, that's why they tried to gank him, yeah, because his flash was
and
down.
And watch right there, just using his ult very well to corral Marin and make sure there wasn't going to be any follow-up.
Yep.
And they're able to clean up the fight. Now, unwise of SKT to even start fighting like that when they didn't have any eyes on most of the players on NaJin, and the mid was pushed up and did make it easy for them just to walk up the river and respond. But all the same, SK Telecom's going to have to try a different strategy. They shouldn't pick champions that kind of lose all the... Well, Xerath won the lane, but wasn't able to prevent Goons roaming right there very effectively. And still, just Xerath, an extremely dangerous champion to pick against that. And I think SK Telecom really had a poor draft phase in that first game, and they're going to need to rectify that a little bit. Maybe got a little bit cocky first round of the draft, selecting Xerath on red side.
Well, what else could that be, really? Yeah, it was a very bold move, and yeah, it is Faker, but we've seen that, you know, even Faker, if you put him in a situation like that, is going to struggle, and he certainly did.
He's your star player. Don't counterpick him.
Yeah, exactly. So, we've got a bit...
An ominous
soundtrack going on. Oh boy, all sorts of new things. And keep in mind, guys, the reason why it's so ominous and mysterious is because teams have the option to switch players between games if they have someone else on their roster that they want to switch with. No changes for NaJin, though.
Got all of the same members.
Yeah.
Of course, that will be Kane, OQ, Goom, Watch, and Duke.
Yep.
Again, once again, why change something if it's working, right, Doa?
Exactly. If it's not broke, don't fix it. That's right. And so, that means that this suspense will continue to build. I'm getting very nervous now. I feel like, you know, one of two things is going to happen here. Either nothing's going to be different on SKT, or some WWF wrestler is going to make a big entrance in the crowd. One of those two things.
It's WWE now.
Oh, it is? Oh, man, I'm truly stuck in the 90s, aren't I? Wait! Wait, what's this? What's this I spy in the SKT booth? It's not Faker! It's Easy Hoon! Faker! Here's how we operate. We pick our star player into an unfavorable match, but then we kick him out when he doesn't do well. So Easy Hoon in for Faker now.
Now, Easy Hoon did have some great performances in the
preseason. He's a fantastic mid laner.
He's a very good mid laner.
Yeah.
And so...
this is kind of funny.
Yeah, easily would be the starting mid laner on probably any other team here in Champions. Maybe not Goon, but definitely a very different style. You can see, now he's the player who likes these more long-range picks. He specializes in that, much less of an assassin player. And
yep,
really bust out the Karthus again. Had a great game on Karthus, and his Jace has been top-notch as well. So... I'm interested to see if they vary up the strategy right here. Now, SK Telecom has played more Siege-style compositions when they've had Easy Hoon.
Very true, and Easy Hoon has always been one of the more kind of hang-back, build-up-the-damage-over-the-game kind of player. But look at that. So accurate, especially with that Jace.
I like how OGN has all of these highlight clips for, like, every player prepared. This is awesome.
Oh, yeah. Oh, man, there's so many highlights to begin with. And look at that, playing with that Karthus. Very rare, yeah.
Oh, no, it wasn't. But, yeah, coming in, doing some work in the hammer stance as Jace, and
power slam!
It does change the dynamic of the team a little bit, I will say, because now this team is basically SK Telecom-esque with Bengi in the jungle.
Oh, he's even got Easy Hoon on his headset, wow. So we know it really is him.
And funny story, why he's named Easy Hoon is his name is actually E.G. Hoon.
Yeah, his Korean name is E.G. Hoon.
So he changed it just to Easy Hoon,
Sounds like
a little bit play on words there. And now the coach is back in the booth for picks and bans. Koma has been unleashed.
He was like yelling on his way into the booth. He's like, all right, you saw what we did to Faker. Easy when you better play well. And reach, oh, the jacket is off. It's serious now. He's like, all right, guys, we got one win, but I'm taking the jacket off. Things are getting real now. We need two wins to take this one home, guys. Koma looking a bit frazzled there. Or he just took off his hat, one of the two. Nice turtleneck, though.
I'm excited to see what SK Telecom does to adapt. It's weird because SK Telecom had some just brilliant pick ban faces during the preseason. But also we've seen the SK Telecom that has very odd pick ban faces like we saw during the Korean regionals right before Worlds. And this was definitely more of the latter.
Well, it's just like Luke Skywalker told the Empire at the end of Return of the Jedi, your overconfidence is your weakness. Yeah, and sometimes it can be for the Empire of SK Telecom. It kind of fits, doesn't it? Well, here we go. Picks and bans for game number two, SKT T1 versus NaJin mFire. Do you realize, Monte Cristo, a new Star Wars movie comes out this year? I get shivers every time I think about it. You don't say anything now because you're just going to, you know, pretend I like the prequels or something, which I don't. Let's talk about picks and bans. LeBlanc, banned by SKT. NaJin bans Lissandra. What do you have to say about that and nothing else?
Expected against Goon. So they are making some modifications. Of course, SK Telecom for top lane bans, Kassadin and Maokai. We'll see if they ban the Kassadin again this time around. Very much a NaJin style pick. I'm surprised they banned Lissandra. They're very worried about that from Mar and Easy Hoon. That's not been a champion that's really been on his radar. Now, Annie.
Wow. Annie ban against Kane.
Haven't seen an Annie ban in a while.
No kidding. We really are going full season three, aren't we? Look at that. Well, although that wasn't really season three until the very end, was it?
If you don't want to deal with the pocket pick, and it can be valuable, and Kane did set up some nice team fights there, and it is kind of a pain to lane against as well if you have a very aggressive duo like OQ and Kane. Now there's Rumble.
We'll ban that against Marin. Not a big shock there.
They don't want a first pick.
Yeah.
So Gnar, the question is, where is the Gnar ban coming in? It has been almost exclusively banned here in Korea. Very rare that we see it even get through bans, and then it is, of course, immediately picked.
It's worth mentioning, too, that Azir is not banned right now, and Kalista is technically available. Now, it usually takes a month or two for Korean teams to pick up a new champion like that, but she is out there.
This is very strong. It's just, I think it's one of those champions that's going to take a lot of time
definitely
to get used to because she plays unlike any other AD carry. So bit more of a specialized skill that ADs are going to have to develop before they're comfortable running it at the professional level.
Do you think they're going to first pick Azir for Easy Hoon? We did see him play it during the preseason. It's a strong pick, but is it strong enough to first pick? Is it good enough to take that risk, you know?
I mean, I don't really see Goon as an Azir player. He's more of an assassin player, generally speaking, so I wouldn't necessarily place the priority on that.
It's not as much his style, but then again, you know, I mean, the theme of the season, Monte Cristo, it's mystery. We don't know what these guys have been playing in the offseason.
I wonder if they're going to take the Maokai first, or the Janna,
Okay.
Here, they did ban out the Maokai last game.
The Janna does make a lot of sense, too. Janna and Maokai both banned last game, This is going to leave two really good picks, though, up for NaJin. I mean, Lee Sin,
Thresh,
still available as well. Thresh, yep, you're right. Jarvan, for that matter, too. And Lee Sin will go ahead and grab that watch, you know, like we, or vice versa, rather.
We'll flip that one around.
You don't choose Lee Sin. Lee Sin chooses you, Monte Cristo. That's how it works here in Korea. Might switch over to that Elise, too. Watch has always been a big-time Elise player.
I'd love to see Duke Sorelli. It's one of my favorite champions to watch him play.
Definitely. It looks like, you know, if they lock these in, very much comfort picks for these two players.
Yeah.
Well, still, comfort picks.
This is the way NaJin tends to draft. When Duke will play a carry-oriented top laner, they will have Watch play something like Elise and build full tank. Because Watch does, at least in Shield, did tend to be the primary tank of the team with Save and Goon opting for more carry-style champions. Now, the Jace pickup.
Well, we didn't even talk about that. That would be a good takeaway from Easy Hoon.
question is, can Goon play it, or is Duke going to play it?
Well, it's one of those flex picks. That's one of the great things about Season 5 right now, is that we have a, I feel like we have a lot more flex picks than we have had in previous seasons.
The thing is, I wouldn't have banned Rumble if I was playing, because the odds of them, of SK Telecom first picking Jace, were not very good, and you could have maybe baited them into a Rumble first pick, and then counter-picked the top lane with Jace, which has been very effective in 1v1 lanes, so I'm not sure if NaJin thought far enough ahead in terms of this draft as to what they were going to do.
Really? Easy Hoon with the Xerath. Okay. Interesting. So,
oh, man.
Poor Faker. Sitting on the bench right now. He's like, oh, no.
Well, the Maokai, in one of those clips, we did see the Xerath-Maokai combo when Easy Hoon was playing on SK Telecom. And of course, that does provide, he's got a ton of peel for himself right now, so that crisis could be a bit averted, but even so, Ahri is going to be a powerful pick right here.
Why do I feel like this season is going to end with Faker and Easy Hoon battling on a mountaintop with claymores, yelling, there can be only one? I feel like that's the direction we're heading now.
That'd be a pretty good end to the season, I think.
It would be awesome, man. Let's talk to OGN and see if we can make that happen. You know, forget the K-pop band. I want the Easy Hoon versus Faker sword duel on top of a mountain. Great. And all right, might be Nami Tristana. Pickups for NaJin. All right. Nami's still a very strong champion and really synergizes well with Jace and Tristana as well.
I like that. We get to see OQ's version of Tristana this game. Generally, I think more suited to his style than Bang's. And Bang going for Corki would be more in his wheelhouse.
It would, and it would start to put together a pretty decent-looking siege comp for SKT as well.
Yeah, that's what they want. They're changing it up. They're going for a little bit of an earlier power spike this game than they did last time, and they'll have a bit more pressure in the lanes this time around, depending, of course, on what NaJin picks, but just... Hey, Binky. Sticking his tongue out, but depending on the champion pool from Goon, unless he has added Jace to his pool...
You know, if your fingers are a little bit too dry, just lick them a little bit so they don't slide off the keys or something, you know?
Yeah, you got to stick them to the keys, you know?
Yeah, if you're playing so fast sometimes, the APM gets so high, you just slip off and you, like, run your hand into the monitor or something. You're like, not again. How many monitors has Benki punched a hole in that way? I wonder.
And there's a Renekton.
Okay. Yep. Not surprising at all. Duke, of course, a longtime Renekton main, and Goon will be taking that Jace in the mid lane if it gets locked in. We'll see if they change it.
I'm going to be very intrigued to see Goon's Jace.
Ooh. Sion is easily one of my favorite champions to watch right now because his ults are always hilarious, man.
It's pretty fun. And no Jarvan to, well, he's got Jarvan on his team, but enemy team Jarvan is kind of the bane of Sion because you can just stop him immediately.
Watch could totally troll him, you know, just cataclysm right on top of him when he's off. Don't do that in solo queue. Pretend I didn't say that.
I think Gundo's the better pick here. You've got a good balance. But now, interestingly, NaJin is in a very similar situation to what SK Telecom. They've gone for the Mundo. They've gone for the Tristana this
late game.
And no, they're not necessarily going to have a lot of pressure in the mid lane either. That's going to be pretty much just long-range farming from Jace and Xerath. So SK Telecom's able to press an advantage with this Corki Xerath. And, of course, you're looking at the Trinity Force, basically a one-item power spike with upgraded boots on Corki. And that's going to coincide with Xerath's power spike off of one or two items as well. And that's when you start grouping and sieging very effectively.
Yep, that's right. Well, let's take a look at the final rosters for game number two. NaJin, SKT, Duke on Dr. Mundo. Marin, Maokai.
Yeah, pretty passive lanes right there. I assume we're going to see standard lanes this game.
Pretty much.
But both back lines coming in with a lot of peel right here.
And Elisa and Jarvan both look very pouty in those pictures, don't they? Like, oh man, I didn't get what I wanted for Christmas. Oh well. Goon on Jace, Easy Hoon on Xerath. We'll see if Easy Hoon Xerath can outperform Faker Xerath in game number one. And Jace, of course, a flashy champion. Can Goon handle it? And OQ on Tristana, bang on Corki.
I'm really looking forward to seeing OQ on Tristana.
Yeah.
He's always had very impressive Tristana games, see if we can pull it out one more time.
I haven't seen enough OQ in general up until now. And Kane on Nami finally down to support, and Wolf manages to pick up the Janna and picks and bans. So here we go, guys. Will NaJin get the 2-0 and make a big statement in the opening match of Champions Spring, or will SKT keep it going? Let's get in the game and find out. You know, the beginning of every season, OGN is like, our intro's not done yet. Let's just get a big clip of Watch and throw it up on the screen. And
it keeps the fangirls happy.
Yeah, everybody's happy with that, you know? It's, like I said, should we have him take off his hood or something? No, we already did that. Just have him look at the camera. Should he snap his fingers this time? No, we already did that too. Just have him look. This is like the purest Watch clip we've ever had at the beginning of a champion season. It's amazing.
Unadulterated Watch.
That's right.
Just the way I like my Watch.
Triple distilled Watch. This is the third time they've done it, so it's the most distilled now. You can even, like, you know, do like the college thing and run it through a Brita filter one more time just to distill it even more. Shut up, Nami.
Your favorite skin is back, Doa.
Guess you can say that.
Ooh, lane swap. NaJin. So showing a little bit on the bottom side and then pulling the old switcheroo.
Yep. The old League of Legends switcheroo.
That's how you roll, man. So interestingly, NaJin looks like they're going to be starting on the opposite side of the jungle as their dual lane. And this time, the lane swap won't be called. And we will see SK Telecom heading right into the bottom lane, but they're not going to freeze this wave. Oh, yes, they are. Now they're finally moving to make sure they can actually get a lane freeze down. They were thinking about going and doing them Krugs, but now both teams will get
Krug life, man.
Krug life.
Damn Krugs.
They decided not that the Krug life wasn't for them, and now they're just going to lane freeze.
Well, just like Lee Sin chooses you, the Krug life does as well. Didn't choose him that time, though. Almost chosen by the Krug life. Yep. The Doa story.
Listen, all right, I'll keep that in mind. I look forward to your autobiography.
It's a little preview there, a little teaser, as they call it these days. Okay. That's right.
A little bit of an atypical start right there with both jungle top lanes beginning on the opposite side of the map of the duo. That can end poorly if you're not careful at times, but instead we are going to have Duke walk right back in the lane. Marn continuing. Jungle follow. You see some stats right there. 100% win on both Corki for Bang and Tristana for OQ.
That KDA though, man, 8.14 for OQ.
It's a pretty impressive Tristana player, that's for sure.
It certainly is. He generally doesn't have very low KDAs in general. Generally. Is that word again?
This is haunting you tonight.
I guess so.
I'm a bit surprised that Duke walked into lane so early, considering that the freeze was achieved in the bottom side by SK Telecom. But they put Kayn down there now, and you can see OQ, he's level 2, but he's holding his skills right now. He hasn't skilled anything up. This is just so you can have control over the lane as Tristana, not uncontrollably push it with explosive shots. So typically we see most Tristanas in lane swap hold off on skilling until pretty late.
Yeah.
But they have that tool in the back pocket should they need to push for any reason. In the meantime, Duke is actually getting some CS right here with the help of Kayn, and Wolf already awaiting Marin's appearance up in the top side. Double Doran's ring now for Marin.
Yeah, and Marin already with a little bit of a CS lead to begin with. So, nice little edge there. And OQ will just let that one push back in top lane for a little while.
Really going to be interested to see how Goon does.
Oh boy, Wolf gets caught by Watch here. He might have to burn a summoner. We'll see. W to knock him away. Nope, doesn't have to flash or anything like that.
No, Easy Hoon has mid pushed up, so he knew he was all right right there.
Yeah, that's right.
Little bit bold to go in. He will take some damage. Now, Goon on Jace. Bit of a new champion for him. Always interesting to see Goon play a new champion because he does it so rarely.
Yeah, I mean, he is one of those players that, like you said, his champion pool's been the same for a long time. You know, when you think about his champion, so yeah, he does prefer more of the assassins, but I feel like Jace could fit into his champion pool.
I mean, he did have very good accuracy with Nidalee spears back in the day. So
yeah, exactly.
It's not the most shocking champion to see him play, but
now we just found this out the other day. The Korean name for the wolves, if you translate it directly from Korean, it just is big growling wolf.
The big one.
Yep, the big growling one.
The big growling one.
Yep, the big growling one, yeah.
It growls twice as much as other wolves because it has two heads.
Double the growl, that's right. You don't get double the gold or experience. What's the deal, Riot? Come on. Jeez. Duke trying his best to farm here.
He's actually doing a surprisingly good job against Bang.
He's keeping up pretty well, yeah.
Now that he's been left to his own devices as well, Corki, very good in these 1v1 lane swaps. Powerful champion, can keep you zoned out pretty nicely, so I think Bang could be playing this a bit more aggressively than he is right now. Mm-hmm. Punishing the Mundo a little more.
Yep. Gonna see a pretty passive early part of this game here. And here comes Nami. Oh boy.
Back in the lane.
That's right.
But that'll give Marin a good chance to go back without his teleport up. He needed that, and Wolf is going to get found out by the spirit of a wolf.
Yep,
the enemy
wolf,
jungle.
The wolf spirit.
Betrayed by his own spirit.
The growling wolf spirit. He's like, you're the spirit of me. Maybe hidden passive, all the wolves are on the wolf's side to begin with.
Wow, that'd be great if you could name yourself like that and get some advantages.
I would name myself Baron immediately.
Baron Slayer.
That's right. I would name myself Exalted with Baron and just see what happens, you know?
Well, not a lot to say about this early game. NaJin playing.
Oh, here we go. Wolf getting caught again. Nice whirlwind, though.
Wolf and Bengi are not actually working particularly well right now to get these wards down. They could be a bit more coordinated in their map movements to make sure that they're not getting chunked out. And that's been a couple close calls, I think, for Wolf right there. And
Bengi, I do feel like he's gotten a bit
lucky. Bengi
should
be backing him up a little bit on some of these moves.
Oh, he's standing in a ward, so they won't be able to make any sort of play on Duke right before level 6 or anything like that. But nice idea. It's the thought that counts, you know.
Wolf standing in a ward, he's going to get bubbled right here. They're waiting for a watch.
He is. Well, they're going to go in onto Duke here. We'll see. Oh, yeah, there's watch. And he just happens to walk out in time. Wow. Wolf has just been extremely lucky this game in several situations.
Yeah, ward expiring right there at the end as well.
Yeah. It's lucky Wolf.
And that roam was actually pretty well disguised, too, because that could have looked like Goon was just going for the blue buff on the the second spawn.
Yep. Oh, OQ. Rocket jumping back under turret. He needs to be a bit careful here because here comes Izu. And yeah, continues to back away. They're going to go ahead and slow him down with the smite. And will they be able to get him? They will. First blood taken by SKT goes to Bengi. Nice.
Yeah, very well coordinated right there. Good chilling smite. Now Maokai is going to get a lot of farm. Put some pressure on the turret by farming behind it. Can they actually pull off a red steal? Looks like no. Oh, Bengi going in. Okay.
He wants more, man. He's not... He's not satisfied with just first blood.
That was pretty dangerous with Easy playing too, so far back in mid lane.
Yep.
They could have opened themselves. If there had been a ward in the river, Duke could have maybe teleported into that one.
See, Bengi's like Rambo, though, because he was like, he just wants basically an unlimited numbers of follow-ups to first blood.
I see.
As many as he can. Get it now? All right, good.
That was good. Good joke, y'all.
Thank you so much.
I wish he looked like Stallone, too.
We can work on that. You know, work out.
Good training montage. That's what Bengi needs.
That's right. Well, we're crossing movies here.
That's true.
Rocky training montage. I mean, we're same actor, but yeah, same jungler. We'll make it happen. And Goon, wow, doing a very good job of pushing Izuhun back, getting a pretty decent CS lead. And putting a lot of pressure on this mid lane. Certainly looking pretty good with the Jace so far.
Yeah, neither mid laner recalling it either, so pretty farm heavy. Not a lot of trading so far in the mid lane. And junglers have been mostly farming here so far. Yeah. One exception, that gank from Bengi. But Duke's not going to be too worried about that. Mm-hmm. Death early. Probably not the end of the world. The question is, can they survive again the siege that's going to come in from Xerath and Corki in about 5 minutes, 5 to 8 minutes. If they continue on their current trajectory and they can get into a position to group up in the mid lane and start knocking down some of these towers, that will be ideal for them.
Well, that's the idea. You know, you want to hit that big mid-game power spike with these quirky siege compositions.
Especially quirky Xerath. That's a big one. You need to nail that power spike, otherwise you do end up in a bit of trouble.
Yeah.
But you also have very good control. Once you can get control of the mid lane, you will default get control of Dragon as well, because the poke will make it very difficult for NaJin to take that objective. And just have to kind of hold on until this Tristana gets big, but they're going to be pretty reliant on OQ in the late game.
Oh boy. We'll take out that ward. And they are starting to push things up just a little bit more. Bengi and Wolf waiting, seeing if they get any sort of opportunities here. Watch is in the other brush, and Najin's the ones with the ward right now. Yeah, so SKT does need to back off. They're going to go in onto OQ here. OQ on his own. Bang is there as well. Valkyrie's in, gets the exhaust down. Rocket jump. There's the knockup. Can they finish him? Doesn't look like it. He still had a summoner heal available.
Wow, that was a great buster shot onto Bengi to make sure that there wasn't anything to close that gap right there.
That's kind of a weird, interesting little interaction there
between
the Dragon's Rage and the buster shot.
It happens sometimes.
It's kind of fun to
see. Tristan and Lee Sin together. So,
yeah.
And he's going to hold on to the turret too. So a lot of resources used on that gank. Important summoner now down and not much gains for SK Telecom.
Not a lot.
Especially with Oki's flash down, Bengi had to use his flash right there as well. Now back to some passive laning, Della. Aren't you excited?
Enjoying your preview of Farm Simulator 2015. It's a brand new edition, guys. It's wonderful.
You'll like it just as much as last year's.
That's right. Or else. I mean, you'll love it. Well, they've got normal lanes now.
Well, this will actually start heating up in terms of action. It's just that both these teams did want to farm in the early game to about that 15-minute mark. NaJin's going to want to farm a little bit longer.
Well, we're about a minute away from when teams are going to start to go for that dragon now as well. It's usually about 13 and a half-ish when we're seeing most of the dragons in these Korean League of Legends games.
Yeah, it'll probably be backed up just a little bit more in this game in particular, just because NaJin not really going to want to go for it earlier, and SKT is dependent on an item power spike, so maybe a little bit later this game, but yeah, generally speaking. And as for this game, it's going to be some more farming for a little bit.
True. Yep. SKT again, you know, they just want to keep that lane pressure on so that when they have the opportunity to maybe go for a dragon, they have the lanes moving the way they want them to.
Martin did a lot of work on the top side, though. Even that little of dirty farming behind the turret there did stack up, as our observer was showing you just a second ago. A lot of damage onto the top side.
Yeah, that thing's almost dead. He hasn't taken a hit on his turret
yet. And bottom turret is very close to being dead as well. So they've got good control over side lanes. And once they push out those side lanes, they're going to be able to put a lot of pressure on mid.
Oh, that was close, man. Didn't steal it. Goon managed to get that blue buff. Nice attempt, though, by EZHoon there.
There's one tower down.
Yep, they're going to start knocking him down, it looks like. It is about that time. Duke's just going to look over the work he did. He's like, yeah, pretty much knocked it down.
Well, he lost his tower.
Oh, you're right. Yeah, he's like, oh, yeah, pretty much lost my tower. Yep, that's it.
He's like, sheds a single tear over the corpse of his tower.
Mundo cry. It's true. Well, the bottom one about ready to fall as well. And yeah, SKT, I mean, it's been such a passive game. Sometimes it looks, you know, like there's not a lot going on. And that's because it's all very subtle. It's all about getting those little bits of tower damage done throughout the first 15 minutes or so. And then it all starts to get knocked down like a string of dominoes.
Yeah, this is an important moment. NaJin actually making a move. EZHoon, this would be a really good dragon for NaJin to take.
Yeah.
Wow, this is great timing for NaJin.
Really
they
smart.
Should not be allowed to get this dragon right here, but due to Goon chunking EZHoon out right there, they're going to find themselves a bit of a window and they're going to grab it.
Yeah, easily taking that dragon.
Important dragon for NaJin because they're able to take some of the wind out of the sails of SK Telecom right after they're going to hit this power spike. We see the Trinity Force now down on Corky. EZHoon went back, so
oop.
Clever little timing window there from NaJin.
Yeah. That really is great, too. like you said, it does kind of stall a bit of the momentum because there was nothing they could do as far as losing
and
these turrets go.
If they hadn't gotten it right then, they would have just gotten their bottom lane shoved in and lost it.
Yeah, the map control would get a little bit too strong for SKT at that point, and you're not going to get the chance to take the dragon then.
Yeah, very, very good play. NaJin's been doing a good job of hitting some narrow timings tonight so far. They're looking quite strong.
Yeah, SKT wants to try to take this red buff. And they won't be able to quite grab it. I think that'd be a bit awkward for Maokai as well, because it is kind of, it looks like a tree animal too, so. I don't think he wants to do that. You ever notice he's got a face on his arm? You ever think he talks to it?
It's like a hand puppet for him?
I guess so.
He's a really good ventriloquist, did you know that? That's why he has that.
I don't see his mouth moves when he talks, that's true. I think a lot of champions are good ventriloquists in that regard. Yeah, that's a good point. See, this is why you're such a great analyst. You're so you're so detail-oriented, Monty. It's impressive stuff.
You know, it's just all about knowing who is and is not a circus performer in this game.
Yeah, that's right. I'm just thinking about Maokai, you know, waking up in the morning. He's like, how you doing, Arm? And Arm's like, well, you slept on me all night. So not so great. Thanks for asking.
Would you say Maokai's act is rather wooden, though?
I would say so, yeah. His delivery is a bit stiff, certainly, yeah. OQ trying to get a little bit of farm done in the bot lane, catching up to Bang. And SKT going to be putting a lot more focus onto this mid lane now. They need to kind of keep that bit of momentum that they built up with the two other outer turrets going.
Yeah. Bang really needs to get into the mid lane.
Yep.
And stop being in the side lane. But he's going to get an opportunity to do it right now. Nope, he's going to recall.
Right now. No.
Well, he pushed the lane up, so knowing that Tristana went back, there was a little bit of time right there. He may want his Sorc Shoes. Yeah, that's what he's going to pick up.
That's really the power spike that you look for with Corki as well. You know, it's T-Force and Sorc Shoes.
Yeah, very nice to be able to have a little bit more punch to your hybrid damage.
And, yeah,
but he's going to go back into the bottom lane. Oh. No, Tristana isn't there.
Oh, well.
So, Bang! Should walk mid right now. And will he do it?
He's going. He's kind of going in that
direction.
He's
going to get the
red buff
first. Oh. He's been distracted.
Double lift, is that you?
gotta get that red buff first.
Back to farm in the bottom.
Oh, AD carries. Always one more thing. I have to get this farm. I have to get this red buff. No, just walk into the mid lane and shoot some rockets.
You know, that bar graph at the end of the game is, you know, if your bar isn't the biggest, it's not going to feel too good. Whether it's champion damage or CS or what have you, you know?
It's okay, he's back in the bottom lane with red buff now.
He's got that. Those minions are just gonna get rocked by that red buff. Oh, snap. Oh, bang, I should say.
Well, it's pretty easy for Naja to hold on to this at the moment without that Corki there.
Pretty much, yeah. I mean, you're going to build a Siege Cop, and at Corki's power spike, why are you not grouping up? It's a little bit confusing.
This is great for NaJin, really. Sure, they're taking a little bit of damage on their tower, but they're buying themselves more time, which is what they need here for this Tristana and this Mundo to really get rolling.
True enough.
SK Telecom really not pressing their advantage particularly well.
Yeah, I mean, it seems like they feel the need to catch up, but what are they catching up to, you know?
Here we go.
Yep, there we go. Now he's got the lanes pushed up as he wants. They're going to go after the mid lane turret. Watch a bit low. Bengi goes in, gets exhausted. Watch will escape. Faker trying to pick up that kill, and he won't be able to quite do it. I mean, easy. Never mind. Bang's got it covered, man. He's like, all right, your ult didn't work. I'll throw mine in there. It's fine. Don't worry about it. Toss him a big one.
Well, and because we did see Watch juke forward right there, based on easy who's ult, he managed to not have anything between him and Rocket. And Bang will take the blue buff right now. Great for SK Telecom as they jump to a pretty substantial gold lead.
Yeah. Well, they really kind of waited to the last minute, but they took good advantage of that power spike. Let's watch that again. Let's watch get rocked.
Yeah, Watch does some pretty deep dancing right here, but
dodges two of them. Oh, wow.
You can only dodge so many skill shots, apparently.
That's true.
Five, and the last one will finish him off.
That's the thing, man. When you're playing DDR, you get tired towards the end. It's true.
Got to keep going.
That's right. We need like a DDR Jarvan skin where he holds his spear behind him like the bar and the machine, you know? And, like does the dancing stuff. I don't know what he'd do with it during the rest of the match. That's not a very well thought out skin idea, I admit.
It's one of your worst ones of all time.
I didn't think that one through, sorry. That was it's our first match in a while, you know. I'm
gotta
shaking
warm
up. Yeah, that's right.
Some new skin ideas.
Still be funny.
Eventually you'll get back to 50 Shades of Graves level.
That's right. I don't know if I want to get back to that level. I scared myself there. Let's produce some fan art that I don't know if I want to see again.
I thought the fan art was quite funny for that.
No, it was great. It's just, you know, it's kind of scary at the same time.
Okay, well.
I'm afraid of my own power. That's really what it's all about, you know. Q lands on Goong. There's a flash. Oh, but the counter flash from Goong is going to escape. Tidal wave goes through. Not a lot of follow-up for NaJin there. Both teams trying to make plays. Ults and summoners used on both sides. And in the end, the dragon is alive and SKT in position to maybe make a play for this one.
Well, they want to poke before they actually start this dragon.
They're going to have to.
The big poke advantage right now, so just get those wards up.
With no ult on Nami, though, that does give him a little bit more safety. Ooh, but Bang takes a big hit from that shock blast. Ouch.
They have twice as much poke, though, as the enemy team. So, yep. Wow, they're actually going to start it right now. This will give Goong a couple more shock blasts to make something work here.
That is very brave. Whirlwind comes through, a ton of damage.
Brave.
There's the ult from Wolf. That's what they were counting on. But, oh, man, this just does not feel good for SKT. I don't know. Can they get it? They do get the dragon. No, never mind. Yeah, SKT does get it. They're going to go in now. A kill comes in for Maokai. Duke tried to dive into the back lines. Didn't end up working. Marin will flash, but the damage from Goong starting to build up doesn't stop Corki from picking up another kill. Now Duke is going deep. He wants it, but the 1v5 a bit too strong for even a Dr. Mundo. And so SKT will walk away with the dragon and three kills.
Yeah, right there, it was looking a little bad for SKT, but they managed to pull off the kiting and then
Bengi. Oh boy, that was close.
Marin right there coming with the teleport flank.
Well,
he's not going to
teleport. Just advance on to Goong. Goong knocks him away, but Easy Hoon right there. Easy Hoon gets low, manages to live. They had just enough damage. Now OQ on the run. And it looks like he's going to be able to escape, yeah. Marin throwing that sapling in there just in case OQ was going to rocket jump over the wall.
Good counterplay by Marin.
Yeah.
Gets the recall off, gets the home guard teleport initiate as they know they successfully guess
it's bold
that NaJin was going to try and siege down that mid lane tower. And they barely get that kill off of a couple of flashes coming in from Marin and Easy Hoon. I thought Easy Hoon was out of range, but he flashed for it and his heal managed to actually things around a little bit right there. So
I mean, you could see what SKT's plan was with that dragon engage. You know, they were counting on Wolf's ultimate to keep them healed enough against the poke of Goong, and it barely worked, but it did work.
Yeah, it did, and also they did manage to land enough skill shots on the kite, whereas Goong prepped it really nicely, but you know, they also just didn't have quite enough engage right there. Mundo couldn't actually lock anybody down with CC in the back line. I think he overcommitted to killing Bengi as well when, well, it doesn't really matter if Lee Sin is alive or not toward the end of one of those fights.
It's
a lot of damage coming in onto Marin, though.
Yeah. And the rest of Najin's coming up. Marin pushes away Duke for the moment, but it looks like NaJin really wants to take this one. I don't know, man. Yeah. Oh, Marin's still taking some hits. He can hide behind that turret so easily, though. All they need to do is keep backing up.
Good pressure from NaJin, though. They are able to regain some control over the top side of the map.
No minion wave to really do any damage to that turret with, though. Oh, found the pink ward.
Yeah, we'll see. Oh, actually, Bang get a recall right now and try and counteract the split push against Corki. And look at this. Grouping with Xerath and Corki. This is what you want to do.
Yep, they're playing out their comp pretty well at this point. And they'll get a lot of damage done to this tier too. Yeah, about a fourth of the health on that turret done just that little rotation alone.
And they're going to grab a blue buff for their trouble on the way out. SK Telecom not really overcommitting to any of these objectives right now. Happy to continue whittling away their opponents. And it's been working. I mean, 6-0. Their patience is certainly paying off. And Easy Hoonies got that Jana has the Medjize now.
Of course, man. Only supports. Only supports can build Medjize and really capitalize on it.
Well, feeling confident.
I am. That's right.
It is Jana playing.
Wasn't his first item, so I mean, not quite as bloodthirsty as he could be, I guess. But
think of how many stacks he would have right now.
I know, yeah.
Four.
Exactly. Could have had four stacks. A whole four, man. Gold efficient.
Thank you. stealing the Gromp right there with Smite over the wall.
No, dude, that was a Krug.
Oh, a Krug, that's right. Sorry.
Come on, you call yourself a professional, you get your Gromps and Krugs mixed up?
I'm sorry, that's I hang
ridiculous.
My head in shame.
The level of professionalism is disgusting.
What kind of noob would mistake a Gromp for a Krug?
Yeah, I know. See, look, clearly a Gromp right there. I don't know. You say Gromp, I say Krug.
There are only so many made-up words a man can keep in his mind, Noah.
That's right, and George Lucas owns the copyright to like 95% of those, so what are we going to do?
It's okay. Nobody will ever want to use Dooku again. So.
Yeah, or Jar Jar. That one's pretty much killed for the life of the known universe. Yep. Which is worse, in your opinion, Dooku or Jar Jar?
Dooku.
You think so?
Yes.
Yeah, I guess so.
100%.
I guess so. I'll give you that one. The implementation was worse on Jar Jar, but the name itself was worse for Dooku. That's
agreed,
true.
Agreed entirely.
Yeah, okay. Glad we got that sorted out.
Jar Jar is more tainted by association. Dooku is just a word that shouldn't be used.
That's true, yeah. Pretty much.
Like Smeb. Smeb is another word that shouldn't be used.
I was going to say, definitely not something you ever name yourself if you're a pro gamer, that's for sure. Yeah. I can't imagine anyone doing that. You know? Window just looked kind of sad there. He's like, well, I'm here, but there's no minions anymore. Can't do anything in the turret. All right. Oh, you're going for the Gromp.
Definitely not a Krug.
Nope, definitely not a Krug. Going for the Gromp sounds like... It could mean any number of things, too. I don't know if I could say that on stream again. I don't know.
Fantastic euphemism you've come up with
there. I guess so. Thank you. I give all the credit to League of Legends, really. Riot Games themselves for you know, helping us do these wonderful things. Thank you. It's great. We'll give it to the Gromp.
Oh, here's we'll a teleport coming in.
That's right. Looks like SKT wants to make something happen, and they will. Marin coming in with that home guard. OQ getting away. The twist advantage goes in onto Kung. There's a bit of a knockup, though, and SKT chasing. Bengi comes in. Nice kick onto Kung. They get the kill. Cataclysm comes through. Doesn't really do a whole lot in terms of stopping SKT. The ult comes in. Whoa! Double from Easyhoon. Not too bad at all. And Duke, will he live? Well, that Aqua Prison certainly seemed to help, but Bang coming over the wall again, and Bengi, he really wants it to, trying to run away. He's got the ult. Can he make it? Gets knocked up. I don't know, man. He's still getting low, and there it is. A kill for Bang at the very last moment. They did the impossible. They killed Dr. Mundo past 25 minutes. It's amazing. And they're going to get a Tier 2 turret out of it as well.
And Marin, his second fantastic teleport flank of this game. And we've seen him do it on other champions like Lissandra as well, just have really good TP home guard engages, pulls it off one more time right here. Duke a little slow on the TP trigger right there, and that allows them to have mostly a 4v5. Pretty easy to clean that one up. And
beautiful.
Duke just couldn't do much in the back line, even when he was there against the Xerath, of course, Corki waiting for him. Let's watch this again. And look at this. Just gets right onto Goom immediately.
Yeah.
And there's just not much that Goom can do. He can't get away. Bengi comes in, gets the kick back in, flashes right over the Dragon Pit to keep himself safe. And now, and
watch
only
this.
Now, do we see the teleport coming in from Mundo. And there you go. Bam.
And apparently, I used my NBA Jam reference way too early in the broadcast.
Wow. Two shots as well. Pulls out of his ult in order to just defend himself.
Oh, well, that's something you don't see every day.
That's
and
not a
then
good
they
sign.
Decided to call a truce, and everyone went home happy.
That's not a good sign. Looks like we may have some... See if that's an observer issue. Or
yeah, hopefully. I've never seen that happen before.
I have not.
It's actually a new one for me.
Looks like our internet is down.
Is it really? Then I wonder if we're talking to ourselves.
I bet you we are talking to ourselves, though.
Let's just keep having a conversation then, man. How you doing? How you doing?
I'm doing well.
It's good.
Look at Watch. I like his hair today.
He looks great today, as usual. Watch is like, well, I mean, at least I'm in the intro for every game. Again.
He's been having a solid night himself. Oh, looks like we're back up now.
Oh, okay.
Maybe
good.
Just a temporary little hiccup right there. Cool. We've got the game paused, so everything
good.
Should be fine.
You know, that's one of the really great things actually about League of Legends is it's hard to actually damage a game that's going enough that you have to restart. You know, it's so rare.
Very rare. That
man, it's really one of my favorite things about casting League of Legends. I hate restarting games, and it looks like we probably won't have to do that as we see the players re-entering the game right now. And hopefully you guys re-entering the stream as well and hearing us. We're assuming.
And we're back on your screen.
That's right. Hey, I just noticed our suits are a slightly different color. What do you know?
Yeah, it's nice.
Yeah.
We've got some variety while still, looking mostly the same.
Our pocket squares are the same color. That's kind of awkward. Yeah, that's a little bit weird.
Don't you hate it when you go to a party and the other guy's pocket square is the same
I know.
As yours?
When I left the house this morning in this suit, when I picked this out of my own closet at my house, and you picked that out of your closet at your house, I totally thought we'd be... We should coordinate better,
yeah,
you know?
Really should.
This is our third year of casting champions together. We should really have this down by now.
It happens a lot, too.
It does.
Remember that one season where we picked rainbow suits the same day,
you
every
know,
day of the season?
I'm really glad you wore that out the other night, you know, when we went and hit the clubs. That was a great choice, I thought. Yeah, that was awesome. Just could not keep the ladies off you. It was really impressive.
Ladies do love the rainbow suits.
That's right. Of course. Who doesn't, you know? You really went for the gromp that night. That's good times, you know? We have a good time here in Seoul, South Korea on League of Legends Champions. It's a great thing. It's a beautiful thing. And I think most everybody's back in the game right now, so we're going to test things, make sure everything is set up. Yeah. What would it be, though, without a little bit of time killing?
Without pauses? I mean, it really wouldn't be talking about our matching suits.
It'd be shorter, you know?
But significantly less entertaining, right?
Yeah, I would say so. I agree. Good point. Another reason why you're such a fantastic analyst. That's right.
Well, getting back into this game a little bit, SK Telecom with a pretty commanding lead right now, nearly 9K gold difference, and Dragon Edge as well. Not even a single kill for NaJin so far. And it's a bit interesting considering what happened last game. Looks like we're catching up right now.
Yeah.
We had a little bit of spectator lay. We're back in the pause, but we're catching up with the game. We may have missed a little bit of the action.
Well, again, I mean, the important thing is that we're back in the game and we don't have to restart, which is awesome. Like, genuinely well done on that stand for Riot. Yeah.
There's OQ.
Right?
Cute OQ is.
Yeah? Is he the new imp, you think? He's got the big, thick glasses. He's got kind of the big, thick hair. He's kind of like...
He's carrying on in the tradition of Korean AD carries.
Yeah, you're right. The big hair, you know? You need it. Korean AD carries and country music stars from the 1950s and 60s. Yeah, both. A lot in common, really, in terms of attire and hairstyles. Yeah, mostly hairstyles. I think he kind of looks like a combination of Imp and Deft, you know?
He does.
Yeah, a little bit. Like, Imp and Deft, you know, left. They went to China, so now OQ has to come in and kind of beat both of them. Yep.
His play style more like Imp, though, generally
That's true.
Speaking.
That is true. We haven't really heard the trash talk, the imp-level trash talk come out of OQ just yet.
I'm waiting for it. It'll be a good day.
I don't know if that's a good thing, but
We need somebody to take Imp's trash-talking mantle.
We do. What does Imp do now, man? I mean, he's in China. Not a lot of people can understand his trash talk these days. How is he going to be happy about people crying now? It's a sad thing. It might make him cry, in fact.
I'm sure I'll find a way. Good translators, I'm sure.
That's right.
We'll facilitate the imp trash talking.
We won't let them take Chober. Well, mostly because he only speaks Korean and English, but we wouldn't let him take him anyway, even if he was studying Chinese.
All right.
We'd take his school books away if we found that out.
Well, back in the game now, Doa.
That's right. So, like you said.
We survived another pause.
We did.
Good work, team.
And I'm sure we'll survive many more. But not today. It'll be perfect from here on out.
Don't speak too soon. Looks like we're going to be heading for game three here, Doa.
I'm confident, man. And that was I'm confident, comma, man, not I'm confident, man. I'm not like a superhero named Confident Man. I'm just a confident man.
Thanks for clearing that up. I was a bit confused there.
I thought it was important. I could tell you were wondering. So SKT with a pretty big lead in this game, like we mentioned during the break. And kind of reverse situations from what we saw in game one.
What is Bengi building?
Bengi.
interesting. Usually you would be building into Righteous Glory, but a couple of them instead. So we'll see what he does with that.
Yep. OQ and Kane want to make a play here. OQ, not quite able to do it. They did get the slot.
So it's like they NaJin trying to close that gold gap a little, get a few towers, scrap them out where they can. OQ is going to start being a threat right now. Oh, good. Oh. Doing some dancing.
There's an ult. Oh, look at that damage! Goom knew. He knew that it was coming.
That was great by
playing
it easier. And they really corralled him in there. He had nowhere to go.
That was like a chess move right there. I mean, he knew he was trapped. He knew it was checkmate there. And all you can do is just dance the king for a few moments before it gets knocked over, I guess.
Did some decent damage to Bang, but now, this pressure coming in. You know, both of these games we've seen one team, first NaJin, now SK Telecom, really hit a power spike nicely and be very unforgiving with a small advantage and snowball out beautifully. That's really, we've seen both one-sided games tonight, but that's a testament to how good both of these teams are. You give them just a little advantage and the snowball just comes so naturally to them.
Yeah, well, I mean, I think it is. You know, it does cement more of what we already knew, that these teams are definitely the top two teams in Korea. Everybody else kind of fighting for third right now. But it is only the very first match of the season. Only going off what we've seen in the preseason, and a lot is definitely going to change.
Yeah, it does seem like NaJin's hopes of coming back into this one are fading, though. With the massive gold lead, and as well as Marin. He's got the frozen heart right now, and that's going to shut down Goong and OQ in a big way. And that, considering they're really the big hopes for NaJin to come back at this stage, I don't really think that there's going to be not much that NaJin can do.
Yeah. Certainly looking that way. Yeah, still not a single kill for NaJin mFire. And Duke, he can try to fire Marin all he can, but Marin's got tenure, apparently.
The tenure tree.
That's right.
And look at that.
They count it in rings.
They're going for the war mod. It's a bit surprising. That's what Bengi was up to.
SKT.
I get it now.
Mystery is over. They're going for Baron, though, and NaJin. Nothing really they can do to stop this, it looks like. Yeah, Goom not in position to go for it. Ooh, nearly was, actually. They managed to kill Bengi.
That was actually really dangerous because Bengi didn't use his smite right there. If Goom had been a little bit closer, he may have been able to take the Baron as well.
Yeah, if that Shock Blast had been slightly more on point, I wonder. Man, that was scary.
Good time, Duke. Has to pop his ult down. Now with Marin having that MR.
Kane!
Oh.
Well, you can dodge a ball, but you can't dodge a missile, apparently.
It does make it quite easy for Bang. And here's another teleporting game.
Seriously, Marin coming in yet again.
He didn't have home guard.
And no harm guard this time, but they do get the flash from Watch, so that certainly does at least equalize summoners. Yeah, that inhibitor is vulnerable too.
Quite easily. Yeah, Bang.
Yep.
Not having to predict much with his rockets. It's like, well, I'm going to put my rocket here, and you either choose to get hit by a Zeratholt, or you choose to get hit by my rocket.
Yeah.
Neither of which are very attractive options.
Well, we have seen SK2 do an extremely good job of just kind of, like you mentioned earlier, corralling, just trapping the players in situations where you just can't avoid the damage. Yep, that poor sapling.
So it's interesting tonight, too, that the more aggressive options have carried the day in both instances. I wonder if we're going to see in the third game both teams going for more aggressive picks, shying away from this Tristana, shying away from this Mundo, and champions that take a lot of ramp time.
Whoa. Kane had a flash there. Marin just going in and activating his ult, going in onto OQ. OQ really low already. Whoa, gets picked off by Easyhoon easily. Another kill as well. Easyhoon is just crushing with this Xerath. Nearly does a lot of damage to Goong as well. Duke getting grinded down. He'll finally be taken out. And now it's back to the inhibitor for SKT. Wolf just going to heal everybody up. And they may be able to actually just end it here.
Yeah, it looks
like
this game is going to be over in 34 minutes. So
nice,
a decisive final push, 15-1 the kills. Two very one-sided games tonight.
Yeah, well, it's going to make for an interesting game number three, guys. We're not done yet, but this one is over. GG, SKT ties it up.
And in this third game, I really hope we see neither team going after these snowball or these like late game champions, because both SK Telecom and NaJin have shown that they can punish these late game champions with their early weaknesses very effectively and snowballed a convincing win. So now, Doa, it's time for more Renekton, less Mundo.
All right, not less Nekton, more
Not less Nekton, more Nekton.
All right. Well, Easy Hoon, fantastic game for him on Xerath, but you can't really compare that against Faker. I mean, Faker was in a very, very different position with that champion. I know people are going to make those comparisons, be like, oh, wow, Easy Hoon did so much better than Faker. But, yeah, you can't really compare those games.
Easy Hoon's a great player, though. And
he is.
Xerath definitely very appropriate for his play style. Had great accuracy on those skill shots, and that'll come out to a win, Easy Hoon.
Yeah.
I think definitely a contender for MVP of that game.
That fan thought Easy Hoon was sexy.
Yeah.
That's exciting, I guess.
It's okay, Watch. You could be sexy, too.
Watch is like, hey, I'm still in the intro every game, so again. So I'm feeling good. And I'm feeling good, too, Monte Cristo, because this is a best of three now. So that means we don't have to end it right here and talk about each team getting a point apiece or something. Now we get to find out who really is going to be the superior team in this match. It's going to be awesome.
Yeah, will we see any substitutions as well? Is Faker going to come back? But also we've seen the SK Telecom that has very odd pick ban phases like we saw during the Korean regionals right before Worlds. And this was definitely more of the latter.
Well, it's just like Luke Skywalker told the Empire at the end of Return of the Jedi, your overconfidence is your weakness. Yeah, and sometimes it can be for the Empire of SK Telecom. It kind of fits, doesn't it? Well, here we go. Picks and bans for game number two, SKT T1 versus NaJin mFire. Do you realize, Monte Cristo, a new Star Wars movie comes out this year? I get shivers every time I think about it. You don't say anything now, because you're just going to, you know, pretend I like the prequels or something, which I don't. Let's talk about picks and bans. LeBlanc, banned by SKT. NaJin bans Lissandra. What do you have to say about that and nothing else?
Expected against Goon. So they are making some modifications, of course, SK Telecom. For top lane bans, Kassadin and Maokai, we'll see if they ban the Kassadin again this time around. Very much a NaJin-style pick. I'm surprised they banned Lissandra. They're very worried about that from Mar and Easy Hoon. That's not been a champion that's really been on his radar. Now,
any ban against Kane.
Haven't seen an any ban in a while.
No kidding. We really are going full Season 3, aren't we? Look at that. Well, although that wasn't really Season 3 until the very end, was it?
If you don't want to deal with the pocket pick and... it can be valuable, and Kane did set up some nice team fights there, and it is kind of a pain to lane against as well if you have a very aggressive duo like OQ and Kane. Now, there's Rumble.
We'll ban that against Marin. Not a big shock there.
They don't want a first pick.
Yep.
So Gnar, the question is, where is the Gnar ban coming in? It has been almost exclusively banned here in Korea. Very rare that we see it even get through bans, and then it is, of course, immediately picked.
It's worth mentioning, too, that Azir is not banned right now, and Kalista is technically available. Now, it usually takes a month or two for Korean teams to pick up a new champion like that, but she is out there.
This is very strong. It's just very effectively, and still just Xerath, an extremely dangerous champion to pick against that. And I think SK Telecom really had a poor draft phase in that first game, and they're going to need to rectify that a little bit. Maybe got a little bit cocky first round of the draft, selecting Xerath on red side.
Well, what else could that be, really? Yeah, it was a very bold move, and yeah, it is Faker, but we've seen that, you know, even Faker, if you put him in a situation like that, is going to struggle, and he certainly did.
He's your star player. Don't counterpick him.
Yeah, exactly. So, we've got a bit...
Ominous
soundtrack going on. Oh boy, all sorts of new things. And keep in mind, guys, the reason why it's so ominous and mysterious is because teams have the option to switch players between games if they have someone else on their roster that they want to switch with. No changes for NaJin, though.
Got all of the same members.
Yeah.
Of course, that will be Kane, OQ, Goom, Watch, and Duke.
Yep.
Coming in once again, why change something if it's working, right, Doa?
Exactly. If it's not broke, don't fix it. That's right. And so, that means that this suspense will continue to build. I'm getting very nervous now. I feel like, you know, one of two things is going to happen here. Either nothing's going to be different on SKT, or some WWF wrestler is going to make a big entrance in the crowd. One of those two things.
It's WWE now.
Oh, it is? Oh, man, I'm truly stuck in the 90s, aren't I? Wait, what's this? What's this I spy in the SKT booth? It's not Faker. It's Easy Hoon. Faker. Here's how we operate. we pick our star player into an unfavorable matchup, and then we kick him out when he doesn't do well. So EasyHoon in for Faker now.
Now, EasyHoon did have some great performances.
He's a fantastic mid laner.
He's a very good mid laner.
Yeah.
And so...
this was kind of funny.
Yeah, easily...
are back on Champion Spring, guys, and the MVP is Duke for that top lane rumble play. He really made a difference with those huge equalizers.
Yeah, great team fighting, great initiation. Hard to pick an MVP this game. Kind of all very well all around played by NaJin.
It was, yeah.
And they really just looked very comfortable with that team composition. They pushed their power spike extremely well, snowballed that game beautifully.
Well, you know, we had that moment where we're like, you know, will NaJin do what they need to do and get the edge they need to finish this early? And they did exactly that.
Wow, look
at this.
This
was a great snipe right there.
Yeah. No, if you look at that rumble, I want to go back to that because he actually hit him in the brush and then hit his escape route on the W jump,
yeah,
too. That is crazy good rumble ult right there. And another excellent one as we see them just clean up. And Duke's going to actually live through this, surprisingly, the rest of his team running up the lane.
Yeah.
Duke kind of walking around the outside of his own equalizer, saving that flash. Oh, he didn't use it. He didn't have his flash there. That's right. He actually gets...
Well, that's why they tried to gank him, yeah, because his flash was
and
down.
And watch right there, just using his ult very well to corral Marin and make sure there wasn't going to be any follow-up.
Yep.
And they're able to clean up the fight. Now, unwise of SKT to even start fighting like that when they didn't have any eyes on most of the players on NaJin, and the mid was pushed up and did make it easy for them just to walk up the river and respond. But all the same, Telecom's going to have to try a different strategy. They shouldn't pick champions that kind of lose all the... Well, Xerath won the lane, but wasn't able to prevent Goons roaming right there. There would be the starting mid laner on probably any other team here in Champions. Maybe not Goon, but definitely a very different style. You can see now he's the player who likes these more long-range picks. He specializes in that, much less of an assassin player. And
yep,
really bust out the Karthus again. Had a great game on Karthus, and his Jace has been top-notch as well. So I'm interested to see if they vary up the strategy right here. Now, SK Telecom has played more Siege-style compositions when they've had EasyHoon.
Very true, and EasyHoon has always been one of the more kind of hang-back, build-up-the-damage-over-the-game kind of player. But look at that. So accurate, especially with that Jace.
I like how OGN has all of these highlight clips with, like, every player prepared. This is awesome.
Oh, yeah. Oh, man, there's so many highlights to begin with. And look at that, playing with that Karthus.
Oh, stole the banner.
Very rare. Yeah.
Oh, no, it wasn't. But, yeah, coming in, doing some work in the hammer stances, Jason.
Power slam!
It does change the dynamic of the team a little bit, I will say, because now this team is basically SK Telecom S with Bengi hit the jungle.
He's even got EasyHoon on his headset. Wow. So we know it really is him.
And funny story, why he's named EasyHoon is his name is actually E.G. Hoon.
Yeah. His Korean name is E.G. Hoon.
So he changed it just to EasyHoon.
Sounds like
a little bit play on words there. And now the coach is back in the booth for picks and bans. Koma
right.
has been unleashed.
He was like yelling on his way into the booth. He's like, all right, you saw what we did to Faker. EasyHoon, you better play well. And reach, oh, the jacket is off. It's serious
now.
He's like, all right, guys, we got one win, but I'm taking the jacket off. Things are getting real now. We need two wins to take this one home, guys. Koma looking a bit frazzled there. Or he just took off his hat, one of the two. Nice turtleneck, though.
I'm excited to see what SK Telecom does to adapt. It's weird because SK Telecom had some just brilliant pick ban faces during the preseason. I think it's one of those champions that's going to take a lot of time
definitely
to get used to because she plays unlike any other AD carry. So
are
a
they?
Bit more of a specialized skill that ADs are going to have to develop before they're comfortable running it at the professional level.
Do you think they're going to first pick Azir for EasyHoon? We did see him play it during the preseason. It's a strong pick, but is it strong enough to first pick? Is it good enough to take that risk, you know?
I mean, I don't really see Goon as an Azir player. He's more of an assassin player, generally speaking. So I wouldn't necessarily place the priority on that.
It's not as much his style, but then again, you know, I mean, the theme of the season, Monte Cristo, it's mystery. We don't know what these guys have been playing in the offseason.
I wonder if they're going to take the Maokai first, or the Janna, yeah.
Okay.
Here, they did ban out the Maokai last game.
The Janna does make a lot of sense, too. Janna and Maokai both banned last game, yeah. This is going to leave two really good picks, though, up for NaJin. I mean, Lee Sin,
Thresh.
Still available as well. Thresh, yep, you're right. Jarvan, for that matter, too. And Lee Sin will go ahead and grab that watch, you know, like we, or vice versa, rather.
Just flip that one around.
You don't choose Lee Sin. Lee Sin chooses you, Monte Cristo. That's how it works here in Korea. Might switch over to that Elise, too. Watch has always been a big-time Elise player.
I'd love to see Duke Cirelli. It's one of my favorite champions to watch him play.
Definitely. It looks like, you know, if they lock these in, very much comfort picks for these two players.
Yeah.
Well, still, comfort picks.
This is the way NaJin tends to draft. When Duke will play a carry-oriented top laner, they will have Watch play something like Elise and build full tank.
Yeah.
Because Watch does, at least in Shield, did tend to be the primary tank of the team, with Save and Goom opting for more carry-style champions. Now, the Jace pickup.
Well, we didn't even talk about that. That would be a good takeaway from Ezeon.
The question is, can Goom play it, or is